With a new batch of 12 senators soon to be proclaimed by the Commission on Elections, talks as to who will be the next Senate president start to heat up, with the names of Senators Cynthia Villar and Juan Miguel Zubiri said to be leading the race. Senator Sherwin Gatchalian and Senate returnees Loren Legarda and Francis Escudero are also reportedly eyeing the post. A contender needs at least 13 votes to corner the Senate presidency. In line with this, two senators told ABS-CBN News that Zubiri has already bagged the majority votes. Their colleagues' disapproval of Villar, the sources say, was due to her bad temper and her conflict of interest as a business magnate should she lead the chamber. One of the sources adds what they would not want to see at the podium is someone who is hot-headed, who doesn't know the rules, and one who doesn't observe proper decorum. The sources also claim Zubiri enjoys the backing of presumptive President Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. Sought for reaction, Villar, through her media relations officer, says it's still too early to discuss the Senate presidency. Zubiri likewise refuses to comment on the matter. But former Senator Antonio Trillanes IV, who worked with Zubiri and Villar, says his information is that Villar is leading the Senate presidency race.
Si Senator Zubiri kasi, ano to eh, ika nga eh, Mr. Congeniality, ano? So, mabait siya sa lahat eh. That may be a problem kung kailangan mong maging independent. Si Senator Cynthia Villar, ano siya eh, unifying figure kasi parang motherly yung dating, parang principal ano, sa eskwelahan.
A Senate President, according to Trillanes, must be an institution veteran and someone who enjoys the respect and good relations of his or her colleagues. He adds a Senate President is third in the Constitution's line of succession, controls the yearly budget of the Senate, and handles the SP office's confidential funds. Trillanes says the Senate President also decides what committee will be given to every member. Another unnamed Senate source also predicts a Villar victory over Zubiri, citing Bongbong Marcos's refusal to endorse Zubiri's father in the congressional race. Another supposed Villar advantage is her husband Manny's strong affiliation to both the Duterte and Marcos camps. Dr. Gene Franco of the University of the Philippines Political Science Department, who incidentally worked as a Senate legislative staff years ago, meanwhile underlines the reality of how one is chosen as a Senate president.
Kung inendorso ng presidente, that's the reality. Wala akong natatandaan naging Senate president na hindi gusto ng presidente. Do kasi importante din na ano eh no, na pagdating sa budget process, pagdating sa kanyang main legislative agenda, priority legislative agenda, eh makuha niya yung suporta ng Senate.
And whether it will be a Villar or Zubiri leadership at the Senate, the scenario will still be the same, according to Franco.
Halimbawa, Senator Villar, magiging as independent, as feisty as the person is ba ang chamber?
No. No. Mm-hmm. And that's something that the entire country must watch out for.
Mm-hmm. Can you say the same thing to a Zubiri leadership?
Pareho eh. Yan na nakikita ko. Mm-hmm. We don't know what developments will happen in the next 3 years, pero ano eh, I think the yung 30 million votes matter a lot in terms of political capital.
Senate Minority Leader Franklin Drilon, who served as Senate President for a number of years, has some reminders to those competing for the chamber's top post. An effective Senate President, he says, is a consensus builder and one who knows how to enter a compromise when crafting laws. Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.